Hello, warm regards and best greetings from Team Banjara. You have shown keen interest in wanting to be a trained professional certified counselor, which means that you have a very genuine intent to reach out to people to help them upheave emotionally. And anyone who even has that intention is, you know, one more a part of us at Banjara. Banjara Academy, we have been a training house and a counseling center for nearly 4 decades now. And even if you have the intent of becoming a counselor, wanting to reach out to people, most welcome to our family. And we have been doing free counseling. Any kind of counseling is totally free at the Academy. And the person who has brought about, you know, this mission and vision, as people usually call it, is Dr. Ali Khwaja. So he is the chairman, he is the founder of the Academy, and I think he saw this many decades back, that counseling is going to be one of the most sought after services in the coming times.
Okay.
Dr. Ali Khwaja started with being a IITian from Mumbai, and he has had varied experiences with, you know, different strata of the society, which later on, you know, egged him to start thinking more about people, human behavior, relationships, everything, and that made him the most renowned psychologist and counselor that he is today. Dr. Ali Khwaja is a TEDx speaker, and he counsels people through the whole life cycle. Children, adolescents, young adults, and people generally, you know, married couple, grief, people usually feel that, oh, counseling, that means problem solving. Counseling, does it mean advising? What is counseling? And what can it be, you know, for a layman? And in the most simplest words, I would actually want you to hear directly from Dr. Ali. And Dr. Ali will join you in just a few seconds from now. Thank you.
Counseling. So often you hear this word here and there, but it is misunderstood, let me tell you that. Many people do not understand what is counseling. So shall I tell you what it is? It's a very simple way of helping a person to help himself. When you want to comb your hair, you have to look in the mirror, and then only you know whether your hairstyle is good or not, isn't it? The counselor is a mental mirror. The counselor reflects back to you what you are doing at the cognitive, at the thought level, at the feeling level, at the action level. So counseling is a very basic, you know, process by which a person can get clarity on himself. A counselor never gives advice. A counselor never tells you what to do. But a counselor empowers you. The counselor helps you to select the right solutions or the right way or how to resolve issues. Now, what if the issue is such where there is no solution to it? You are stuck. The counselor helps you to cope. How to best cope with a situation which is not in your control, but not get pulled down by it. This is what counseling is all about. It is purely non-directive. It is not non-invasive. There, nobody is pumping chemicals into you, nobody is sticking injections into you, nobody is, you know, distracting you from what you are doing. But it's such a wonderful process. I don't want to say too much about it, because I feel that it is something which you have to experience by yourself. When you experience counseling, either as a counselee or as a counselor, then you realize the efficacy of it. That is what I am looking at. That if you want to get into the world of counseling, understanding human behavior, it opens out an absolutely new world to you. It helps you think deeper. It helps you to introspect about what you are and where you are. And subsequently, it helps you to reach out to people. Something which gives you such tremendous, whether you do it commercially or professionally, or whether you do it as a social service, that's entirely up to you. But when you learn counseling, when you practice counseling, and when you actually counsel people, the satisfaction that it gives you is something which you have to experience, and then only you know. On my part, I am there. I can take you through that whole journey from A to Z because I enjoy doing it. It's not my vocation or profession. I don't, you know, think of it as something which is my duty or something. I just love doing it. All the time that I spend helping people to become counselors and to train themselves is a joy. It's a pleasure for me. And there is no time limit as far as I am concerned. I'm willing to put in all my efforts if I know that you have that genuine interest, and one fine day you're going to become a counselor and you're going to in turn reach out to so many people. Best of luck.